In entertainment, Avatar and Guardians of the Galaxy star Zoe Saldana steps into one of her most challenging roles ever as a singing and dancing lawyer in Emilia Perez. Our Hollywood correspondent Yong Chavez speaks with the actress about her decision to embrace the challenge of the genre-defying film.
Through her iconic roles in Avatar and Guardians of the Galaxy and their sequels, Zoe Saldana is that rare actress who has starred in several of the highest-grossing films of all time. Even though her path to recognition, like many actresses of color in Hollywood, hasn't been without its challenges.
No, I'm not English. Why?
She has made her mark by playing unforgettable characters, and the actress shares her process in creating them.
If a woman feels like she's only half represented in the way that she is speaking for herself or navigating the world around her in the story, then I can't play that because I don't know how to play an incomplete person. To me, what makes somebody complete is all of their ebbs and flows, their rights and their wrongs and their feelings and their thoughts.
Rita Mora Castro, soy la abogada, trabajo con su marido.
In Emilia Perez, she plays Rita, an unappreciated lawyer in a dead-end job who was captivated by another person's courage. The story speaks to anyone who's ever yearned for something greater, despite the obstacles, mirroring the star's own journey in the industry. When it comes to choosing roles, the actress says she follows her heart because it sharpens her instinct.
There's been times in which I've made decisions because others had advised me to do it, and those experiences were unfulfilling, or it was hard for me to connect because it wasn't something that came from me.
With its unique telenovela-influenced musical storytelling, in Emilia Perez, she acts, sings, and dances, and in the process, pushing herself outside of her comfort zone to give voice to a character who might otherwise remain unseen. The film's women, Saldana, Carla Sofia Gascon, Selena Gomez, and Adriana Paz, shared the Best Actress trophy at this year's Cannes Film Festival.
Very early on, I understood that these musical breaths were going to allow Rita to really think and feel openly. Mm-hmm. Because Rita generally is a very timid person. She's very smart and she has desire. She's desperate to be relevant and to be successful, but she doesn't have the courage that Emilia has, which is why she's so drawn to her, seduced by her, and was this level of thrill, you know, because thrill is fear but curiosity, right? She's a hard person to read. That required just me learning the choreography, me singing the songs, but it was never for the intention of being the entertainer in the story. I never broke the story down that way. I saw four women that, by the hook or by the crook, were looking for their freedom.
Emilia Perez starts playing in select theaters November 1 and will start streaming on Netflix on November 13. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.
Crisis averted at Metro Manila's main gateway. The operator of NAIA says it has prepared contingency measures to prevent a water supply interruption at Terminal 3. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual joins us on the line for more on this story. Hi, Jackie. What can you tell us?
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Stanley. The new NAIA InfraCorp, or NNIC, operator of Manila's Ninoy Aquino International Airport, has prepared for what could have been a waterless airport this November 1st. NNIC has earlier announced of a scheduled water service interruption conducted by Maynilad from 2 p.m. of November 1 to 6 a.m. of November 2. The service interruption will affect parts of Pasay, Parañaque, and Muntinlupa due to repair and maintenance at the Putatan and Poblacion water treatment plants. And one of the areas affected is NAIA Terminal 3. But the Manila International Airport Authority regulator of NAIA said there is still water supply in toilets due to the contingency measures done by NNIC. NNIC General Manager Angelito Alvarez also told ABS-CBN that there is still water supply, although there was a weekend water pressure, but very manageable. And he mentioned, or Alvarez mentioned, that they have water tanks on standby. NNIC has earlier said that they will use the terminal's water reserves of about 3.2 million liters, enough for a few days depending on the consumption. Bendijo added that this amount is sufficient to serve NAIA during the expected 16-hour water shutdown. Bendijo added that there are fewer passengers at NAIA this November 1st and November 2nd, which will also lessen the consumption of water at the terminal. He still urges passengers to conserve water and hopes that repair works will be completed as soon as possible. Now, Stanley, so far operations at the airport are smooth, and they expect the number of passengers to be lower compared to previous days, and the number of passengers will increase again by Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday following the All Saints and All Souls Day weekend. And that's the latest from NAIA. Back to you, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual.